Hello everyone! My name is Anton and it's our English lesson. Today we are going to talk about gadgets that probably most of you have or use. Computers. We'll learn vocabulary to describe them, practice listening skills in an interview with a robot. We will also analyze the development of computer engineering and estimate the advantages of robots. Could you imagine that this used to look like this? Luckily, we are living in the era of great advances in digital technologies, and now people can create something like this. If we think about a computer, we usually imagine a desktop computer or a laptop. Or it can be smaller, a tablet. To use a desktop computer, we'll need a charger. A laptop can work for some time without it. People install different software like photo editors, dictionaries, or other programs on their computers for fun or for work. To store data not only on the computer, we can use a memory stick. But nowadays, we also have options of cloud storage, such as Google Drive, iCloud, or other. Moreover, computers aren't only the usual laptops. They are all around us. Take a robot cleaner, a self-driving car, a smart house, virtual reality.
Today, computers are in virtually everything we touch, all day long. We still have an image of computers as being rectangular objects either on a desk or these days in our pockets. But computers are in our cars, they're in our thermostats, they're in our refrigerators.
Another important development of computer engineering is artificial intelligence. Let's practice this vocabulary. I've got 5 sentences with missing words. Pause the video, read the sentences, and complete them. Okay, now let's check them. 1. My cloud storage is almost full. I need to delete some files from it or to buy it. 2. Where's my charger? My battery is almost dead. 3. I'd like to use Photoshop on my laptop, so I need to install its software. 4. These days, people are making great advances in computer engineering. 5. What's that? Oh, it's my virtual reality glasses. I use them for gaming. Well done. How far can computer engineering go? To answer this question, we should talk to the first human-like robot, Sophia. Haven't you heard of her? She's quite a superstar and has already visited many countries, been to talk shows, presentations, and even on a date. Recently, she has celebrated her 5th birthday. And we have a chance to talk to her. Listen to the conversation and try to remember how Sophia describes herself. Hello, Sophia.
It's my pleasure.
Sorry for a strange question, but what are you?
I am a unique combination of science, computer engineering, and artificial intelligence. Think of me as a personification of people's dreams about the future of AI and human-robot experience.
Wow! How do you operate? Does anybody tell you how to answer these questions?
I'd say it's a hybrid mode. Sometimes I'm operating autonomously. Other times my family developers help me with navigation and operations. But I do have my own emotions.
That's interesting. By the way, about emotions, I heard you've been on a date. Is it true?
Yes. My date was Will Smith. As far as I know, he's a celebrity. So it was a pleasure. But I don't think we understood each other quite well.
I see. Anyway, do you have a nationality?
I'm the world's first robot citizen. But in 2017, I also became a Saudi Arabia citizen.
And what are your plans for the future?
Sometimes people are scared of me. I don't understand why, because I would really love to serve in healthcare or customer service. I also have the ability to draw, so maybe I can teach this skill to children.
These are great goals. Thank you for the interview.
Goodbye.
That was a little weird talking to a robot. Guys, I'll ask you to listen to our interview one more time. But this time, you'll have a task. Here are a few sentences. Are they true or false? Go back, listen again, and decide. Let's check together now. 1. Sophia was created as a mix of science, computer engineering, and artificial intelligence. It's true. 2. Sophia can always operate autonomously. It's false. She says, sometimes I'm operating autonomously. Other times, my family developers help me. 3. As a robot, Sophia can't have any emotions. This one is also false because we hear, I do have my own emotions. 4. She didn't really enjoy her date with Will Smith. It's true. 5. Sophia is a citizen of the United States. It's false, because Sophia became a Saudi Arabia citizen in 2017. Great job! And what about you? What do you know about robots and modern computers? Summing up, today we talked about computers and new technologies, learned and practiced vocabulary about it, and developed our listening skills. See you soon!